Good evening and welcome to Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. Republican presidential candidates are coming to Arizona in December for a nationally televised debate. Governor Jan Brewer announced today that the state Republican Party has reached an agreement with CNN to produce the debate on December 1st. The debate will air live on CNN and worldwide on CNN International. Arizona is getting a new medical school this week. The Mayo Clinic announced plans to establish a branch of the Mayo Medical School on its Scottsdale campus. The new school will be called Mayo Medical School Arizona Campus, and it will feature a key collaboration with Arizona State University. Here to talk about the school and how it will impact health care and health education is Dr. Wyatt Decker, CEO of the Mayo Clinic in Arizona, and ASU President Dr. Michael Crow. Good to see you both here on Horizon. Thanks for joining us.
Great to be here.
$266 million branch here, and this will be connected to the existing campus?
That's right. The medical school facility will be on our Scottsdale campus.
How many students are you anticipating here?
48 students will be admitted to each class. So.
And basically, as far as the campus is concerned, remodeling, re-existing these structures, really not much in the way of new construction, I would imagine.
That's right. We'll be refitting some of our existing facilities to accommodate the medical school.
Now, I understand a joint degree program is involved here. Can you explain that for us?
Yes. ASU, through our partnership with Mayo Clinic, will focus on a graduate degree in the science of healthcare delivery, which will be a component part of producing a more broadly educated type of physician.
And that means someone, what, different healthcare delivery systems, different personalized approach, these sorts of things?
It means everything. It means scientific aspects of enhancing health outcomes, understanding health outcomes, personalized medicine aspects, biomedical informatics aspects, a range of those things together.
So the medical degree kind of comes from Mayo Clinic, correct?
That's correct. But even the medical degree will include a collaboration with our colleagues at ASU. So the degree and the embedded master's training in the science of healthcare delivery will be fully integrated together in the curriculum and will involve a collaboration with ASU and the Mayo Clinic.
Is that different than from what we see at other medical schools around the country?
Absolutely. We're incredibly excited about this medical school, not only because the nation has a national shortage of physicians, and this will help, and Arizona is actually ranked 37th in the nation in terms of physicians per 1,000 population. So this will help with physician supply, but even more important and more exciting is the element of the science of healthcare delivery and the curriculum that these students will be trained in.
Some of the basics here again, students will be based in Scottsdale, based in Tempe, downtown. Where will they be kind of focusing their attention?
Well, medical students will concentrate their initial years on the Scottsdale campus, but then they'll be working in the rest of the clinic for their third and fourth year. ASU faculty will be a part of all of that, and so it's not a single place. It's not like students just sitting in a room somewhere. They'll be a part of the Mayo Clinic organization on its multiple campuses, and they'll be engaging in learning experiences and teaching experiences everywhere.
And is it like a biomedical informatics, some sort of something?
Right.
Already talk to us about that.
So we ASU moved our department of biomedical informatics into the Mayo Clinic, and it has become a joint initiative in the sense where biomedical informatics, which is an undergraduate and graduate degree program for us and a research intensive unit, is already on the Scottsdale campus and is connecting to the Rochester campus and the Jacksonville campus, and so it's a part of our overall collaboration.
And I was going to ask you, why ASU? Why the collaboration there? I think Dr. Crow just kind of gave us a pretty good example.
Well, it's a perfect example, and I think it's actually unusual to see the level of collaboration that we're seeing between a major university and a big academic medical center such as Mayo Clinic, and we feel that it's a perfect union of forces in that ASU's mission to deliver outstanding education that impacts society and Mayo Clinic's mission to deliver outstanding value-driven care are very closely aligned.
And I ask why ASU, why Mayo Clinic? I mean, there was, as we all know, the U of A, there was kind of a deal there that kind of fell through. What's different here?
I think what's different is that Mayo Clinic is a comprehensive, nationally based, nationally focused comprehensive clinical organization. ASU is a comprehensive university. That is, we have hundreds of subjects. It turns out if you take a comprehensive clinical organization and a comprehensive university, and you find ways to overlap, there's many things that you can work on together. And in a sense, there's no medical school between us. So we're able to advance without a medical school, providing all of the assets that we have to the Mayo Clinic as a comprehensive clinical enterprise. And it just is a I think, a fantastic new way to advance the overall health outcomes of the broader population.
How did the idea get started? How long did it take to get to this point?
Well, we've been working with Mayo Clinic for about 9 years on a range of initiative, multiple research projects, research initiatives, research laboratories, joint degree programs, nursing programs, a wide range of things. And these discussions relative to the medical school have been underway for a couple of years from a conceptualization perspective and have just reached fruition.
As far as reaching fruition, though, and actually getting this going, there still needs to be some financing to make this a done deal?
That's correct. So to launch the medical school, we will be looking to raise about $75 million in philanthropy, and that will be complemented by an investment of the Mayo Clinic of $45 million. Ultimately, as you mentioned, it will require about $266 million to endow the medical school in perpetuity. So it's a big lift.
But as far as just getting things started and getting the process underway, probably, I would imagine, not the full 266.
That's correct. So we at Mayo Clinic have already committed the funding for this $45 million. We will need to raise commitments up to $75 million before the med school opens its doors.
And when do you think the med school could open its doors?
I think the target is the fall of 2014, and the university is committed to advance our component parts through our own university planning and university activities.
Why does the Valley, which sorely needed a medical school and may now be looking at two, and certainly there's some others in the Valley as well, but why does the Valley need, in this case, another medical school?
Well, it's not about how many medical schools are needed or just about the number of physicians that are produced. What it's really about is finding new ways to deliver health care at a lower cost. And to do that, you have to do a number of things, including finding ways to produce doctors that are differentiated, that have a broader set of skills, and find new ways to work together between clinical organizations and universities. And so what we're really after, the ultimate outcome here, is enhanced health care delivery at a lower cost on a large scale, and this is a part of all of that.
And obviously the other Mayo campuses are a part of this as well, as you
That's
mentioned
correct.
Earlier. Is that going to be logistically speaking, is that going to be a bit of a challenge?
No, we don't expect so. So the students that matriculate here in Arizona will live and be based in Arizona. They'll have opportunities to rotate clinically at our other facilities in Minnesota or Florida. And currently, our Mayo Medical students who are based in Minnesota come to rotate at Mayo Clinic in Arizona. And actually, many have enrolled in degree programs simultaneously with ASU.
I remember when Mayo Clinic first came out to Arizona.
Yeah.
That was a big deal. It's like the Mayo Clinic is coming. Why did the Mayo Clinic come here? And why? This is quite the commitment to Arizona. This is not a pull up the stakes in another 5 years and you're out of here.
Yeah.
Why the commitment?
Mayo Clinic sees Arizona as a terrific opportunity to deliver the kind of care that we offer, and that's an integrated, multidisciplinary approach to high values or very efficient models of care. We think that through the partnership with ASU, we're in a unique setting to really move medical education forward and do an even better job caring for our patients in the Valley.
And you're seeing that obviously as well. This has to be a pretty good opportunity to try some new things, some innovative things, and get ASU on the map as far as this kind of medical research and medical education is concerned.
Well, our focus is really on changing health outcomes. And so what we're doing is we're taking our relationship with the Mayo Clinic. We're building a new program in nutrition and nutrition-related areas. We're building this new unit related to the science of healthcare delivery. We've already have a relationship related to nursing, biomedical informatics. We're trying to piece all of the things together that can help lay down the, in a sense, the intellectual track that can get healthcare moving in a new direction. And our relationship with the Mayo Clinic helps us to be able to do that. We need new track because right now we have a grossly underperforming and excessively expensive healthcare enterprise, and so we need new approaches. Mayo is committed to new approaches, and we're trying to be of assistance to them.
And Arizona is the land of new approaches. I mean,
absolutely.
It's kind of almost a tabula rasa out here, isn't it?
That's right. And the concept of the science of healthcare delivery, where it really will be a game changer in medical education, is currently physicians are trained in all medical schools to be technically competent and provide compassionate care. But imagine, if you would, a patient who suffers chest pain and is having a heart attack. They go to an emergency department in a hospital. The care they receive can be technically excellent, but the providers traditionally have almost no education in the system, the system that could have perhaps prevented this incident in the first place. And once that patient arrives, how did they get there? Was it efficient and safe? Once they're in the system, how well coordinated is their care? And so those are the elements, by utilizing better data analysis and systems engineering, that we believe that physicians formally trained in these techniques will be able to contribute to healthcare.
All right, well, we'll keep an eye on the progress, and hopefully 2014 we'll see the beginning of a great relationship. Gentlemen, thank you so much.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Thank you.